Hello, today we are going to work on place value. I want to start by reviewing how to say numbers in standard form. Boys and girls, this is, it can be a tricky skill to learn how to say larger digit numbers. I want to show you a trick though that will make it easy for you. After we do standard form, we'll work on written form and then we'll go on into expanded form. Then after we do that, we'll be able to compare numbers with symbols. Let's start by looking at this large number. You know that this is the ones place, tens, hundreds, thousands, ten thousands, and hundred thousands. A lot of my brightest students have trouble with saying larger digit numbers. Here's the trick. If you can just say this number all by itself, then you are going to do great. If you can just say this number all by itself, you will also do great. Now, this comma right here stands for a special word, and the word is thousand. So really all you have to do is be able to say a number in the hundreds place, like 475. And how would you say this number? 283, right? And if you can remember that the comma means thousand, then you would be able to put this whole thing together and say it correctly. Listen to me and then we'll try one together. 283,475. That's it. All right. Now, what if we added another number over here? Let's add a 3 and an additional comma. We need another box. Boys and girls, these boxes, what they do is represent periods. This is the ones period, the thousands period, and this will be the millions period. I bet you already know what this comma right here is going to represent. Yes, million. All right, so can you say this number? 3, right? Okay, so that's easy. So if you will break these numbers down and remember the boxes, even when they're not there, you will not fail. 3,283,475. And we said this big number without any problems. Let's try one more. Let's do another number. And let's try this one. I like the boxes. Until we get really good at it, the boxes help us remember that you just break it down and it makes it so much easier. Don't forget, this stands for million. This comma stands for thousand. Ready? 5,701,392. Did you notice that I did not say the word and when I said this number? And that's a really an error that a lot of students make when they say these larger numbers. They'll put the word and somewhere around in here, and they might say 5,701,392, but that is incorrect. We only use the word and when we have a decimal number. And for now, boys and girls, this is just a whole number. So we will not use the word and until we have the decimal. Now, what if we wanted to write one of these large standard form numbers in word form? It would be long, wouldn't it? If you can say it correctly, you can surely write it, or at least you will be able to recognize it written correctly. All right, so now we're going to write the number in standard, that is in standard form, in word form. Let's start with the first number, 3. Notice that I need the word million because of the comma. And go ahead and put the comma as we were writing this to let us know that this is the millions place. So 3 million, the next words we will need will be, however we say this, 283,000. So that's exactly, however we say it will be exactly how we will write it. 283,000. Place the comma. And now for the last group, which is the ones period, we need 475. So I'm going to go down to the next line because I'm out of space. And 75. Now, whether you know how to spell all these words correctly or not, you would be able to recognize this in a multiple choice problem because you know how to say this number correctly now. So you could pick this out. 3,283,475. Does that give you confidence? All it is, break them up in boxes. Remember the meanings of the commas, and you can do it every time. You try.